Hi there, and welcome to another episode of Road Choice TV. I'm your host, Justin, and this episode will conclude my air disc brake series. We're going to talk a little bit about how to service brake pads and the benefits of maintenance. So I'm here with Jay again, and he's going to walk us through brake pad changes and also give us more information on the monetary and maintenance advantages of air disc brakes.
Thanks for having me again. One of the main advantages is the average time it takes to do a pad replacement. It's significantly less than a brake shoe, which is really good for business and for uptime.
So what else have you found beneficial about servicing air disc brakes?
Well, once your brake is adjusted and the pads are off the rotor, it's very simple to change the pads. You really only have to remove this pad retaining strap right here, which is a very, very simple process. And when doing a standard PM, the only tool that you really need is a dial indicator in order to check that the axial and the radial play of the brake is within the caliper specifications.
So from your experience, how long does it usually take to service air disc brakes compared to drum? And do you find that it's any easier?
When we look at the small number of components that must be removed in order to service disc brakes, it's easy to see that they offer a time and service advantage. First, you gain proper clearance between the pads and the rotor with a nut back here, and then it's one other additional nut in order to remove this pad retaining strap and to take the pads out.
So what's the average lifespan for a set of air brake pads?
Well, it's not uncommon for a long haul tractor for air disc brake pads to last over 500,000 miles, and even longer for trailers.
Now that's really impressive. But now I want to get into inspections. You know, that's always a common concern for people with air disc brakes. What are DOT inspectors really looking for when they're inspecting a vehicle with air disc brakes?
Well, because so much of the braking process is done inside the caliper for an air disc brake, there are actually fewer external checkpoints during a wheels-on inspection. They'll try to gain a picture of the brake health by making sure that the caliper is properly mounted to the vehicle and that the chamber is properly mounted to the caliper. They will then try to discern how much brake lining life is left by looking at the visual wear indicator that's located on the backside of this brake.
So it sounds like that will definitely shave a lot of time off inspections, which can be a huge advantage, especially if you're pressed for time to deliver. Well, that's it, guys. I know this has been extremely helpful for me to understand more about air disc brakes. And I want to thank Jay again for taking time with us today on our last Road Choice TV series on air disc brakes. Well, I hope all these episodes have been beneficial. And as always, you can email me with any questions to justin@roadchoice.com and I'll get you an answer. Or, for more information on these new standards of safety that Jay touched on today, visit our website at roadchoice.com. Don't forget, you can also stop by your local Road Choice parts counter to enjoy the benefits of the Road Choice brand nationwide, ready to serve you 24/7, 365 days a year. Well, this concludes our series on air disc brakes. I'll see you next time.